both the NDPI board and the PIN board, who are fully represented here. I appreciate your support. And of course, without the support of our partners, many of whom are here in the room, I fear leaving anyone out if I start to list them. But I must recognize the efforts of the Demand Alliance, which was created as part of our overall strategy to enhance collaboration and partnership in the Niger Delta region. Demand stands for Developing Market Alliances in the Niger Delta. Members of the alliance include UK Department of International Development, DFID, International Fertilizer Development Corporation, IFDC, Market 2 Project, and of course, the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, just to mention a few. I speak on behalf of everyone at PIND when I say thank you for working with us, and thank you for sharing in our belief that one day the Niger Delta will be a place that we all seek and be happy to be in. I really don't know how many of us are quite familiar with the many things that PIN does, so just permit me to share with you some of the things that an introduction into who PIN is. We are a Nigerian non-profit organization building partnerships for peace and equitable economic development in the Niger Delta region. To achieve this, we have four mutually reinforcing program areas, namely economic development, capacity building, peace building, and analysis and advocacy. We host this forum every year, so I can say boldly that NDDF is not a jamboree. With each edition, the audience at NDDF increases. The number of stakeholders interested in the forum increases. And in the last 2 years, we have been able to involve the governments of the host states directly in the planning of NDDF in order for them to take ownership of and drive the policy recommendations that come out of the forum. We no longer need to convince anyone as to the importance of dialogue and the collective actions for the Niger Delta, as our partners now on their own individually take on policy recommendations and decisions reached at the NDDF into their respective work plans. If you permit at this point, let me share some of the achievements we have achieved since we started in 2012. In 2012, when we held the first NDDF forum, the theme that year was supporting poverty reduction through partnership. Because it was the very first one we were looking at that time, we needed to look at a broad topic in terms of what the theme should be. It was held in Port Harcourt in 2012, and we had in attendance about 187 persons. And one of the key outcomes of that discussion was the inauguration of the Demand Alliance, which I spoke to earlier on. In 2013, the theme became a little narrowed. We moved down a little because now we had a better sense of what some of the issues were. And so the theme for that year was promoting new approaches for micro, small, and medium enterprise development. This had in attendance 320 people. It was an invite only. It was open to everybody. And it was held in Benin City, the capital of Edo State. And the key outcome from that discussion was introduction of the agri-business sector to equipment leasing. It was one of the issues that came out as a key component in order to drive SMEs. And so one of the deliverables that came out of that conversation was introduction of small SMEs into leasing as a way of funding financing their projects. In 2014, the team also, for that year, was unlocking investment opportunities in agriculture in the Niger Delta for regional competitiveness. Now we're also looking at specific issues. Now we're looking in the space of agriculture. And in that same tour, it was also open to everybody. The attendance was over 700 people attended that forum. One of the outcomes of that forum was there must be increased spending on crop production, food processing and preservation, livestock and fisheries production, machinery and more. Those are some of the key issues that came out of that forum. By 2014, We also had a session in Washington, D.C. We also look at going international, particularly bearing in mind, too, that one of our partners is NDPI that is based in the, in the U.S. And so in that year, in that forum, it was an invite only. We're trying to try a different format. It was an invite only forum. If you notice, attendance just 60 persons, but the theme was collaboration for growth and stability in the Niger Delta region. And one of the key outcomes of that conversation was it is essential to simultaneously focus on peace building and economic security. They're not exclusive, one fits into the other. That same year, too, in the phase of going international, we also held a forum in London. And the theme for that year was delivering sustainable and equitable socioeconomic improvement through industrial diversification. In 2015 also, we had the forum in Washington, D.C. That was last year. And the theme for last year was generating economic development through infrastructure investments in the Niger Delta. And attendance, the same format for the DC event was invite only, 50 persons. But one of the key deliverables, or one of the key outcomes of that forum was leadership commitment. That's government, private sector, civil society, donor agencies to take action in support of economic development in the Niger Delta. Locally, too, we felt that the theme in previous years it was driven by PIND, but by 2014, 2015, realized the need for us to actively engage our partners. So it's not just a PIND activity. And so we had more involvement of our partners, members of the Demand Alliance play key role in shaping the dialogue, shaping the content of the forum. And that, of course, the same approach followed us in 2016. And so that year, for last year, the theme was collaborative effort for stimulating investment and inclusive growth in the Niger Delta. At that time, too, it was now we're going to look, seeing the model of invite only versus invite come all, we realized that it didn't make sense. It was more productive conversation if we had an invite only kind of format. And so last year we had 250 persons versus the over 700 we had the previous year. And the location was Asaba. And this was one of the first ones that we had a lot, very strong government participation. We had Vice President presented at that forum. We had governors, both Imo, Abia, and even Delta State, who were all presented at that forum. And one of the key outcomes of that forum was the need for more coherent and cohesive alignment on regional initiative and actions by government. And we're beginning to see that that's beginning to form the dialogue even in government today. We have institutions like NDDC, Minister of Niger Delta Affairs, talking about the need for collaboration and cohesion in terms of the development agenda. I mean, the Niger Delta ultimately is a beneficiary of whatever development effort that any of those institutions carry out. And so there's a need for us to collaborate. Last night, we were with the Excellency, the Governor of Imo State, and he also talked about the need for collaboration, that if there's no collaboration, there's a risk that government institutions will, in one singular community, build boreholes. You might have one community of less than 1,000 people, an oil company will build a classroom block, NDDC will build a classroom block, Minister of Niger Delta will build a classroom block, a local government will build a classroom block for who? Because there's no coordination, there's no one is not talking to the other. But he also sees that that's a gap that can be filled. Just to summarize, some of the things that have come out of the forum and how our partners have also taken the leadership in incorporating those issues in their own plans. Because one of the focus for us as a forum is that whatever action items come out of the forum like this is not just for PIND to do, but individual partners take their own components and run with them, incorporate them and see and run with specific components that relate to what they do. And so for us, that's part of the way we define the success of the NDDF. So just on a general note, there's a general understanding of the need for dialogue and collective action for Niger Delta to move forward. The BRAID Commission, the BRAID starts for actually Bayelsa, Rivers, Akwa Ibom, Cross River, Edo, and Delta State. What some people call the South-South State is an acronym for that. Has progressed some of the agricultural and investment policy recommendations from NDDF to work directly with the commissioners of six states they are mandated to work in. I'm sure our friend Chooks will talk a lot about that during his own session. PIN's 2012 International Women's Day hashtag Pledge for Parity event was an opportunity to echo the challenges and issues women farmers face. Some of these issues were things like access to finance, access to land, need for better information, knowledge sharing, and capacity building empowerment for women farmers. At that event, we had more than 300 women participate in that physically, and of course, we used the online platform for broadcasting some of the outcomes of those discussions. Taking the cue from the NDDF, the Abia State government in early this year organized their own Abia Urban Development Forum with focus on developing and rehabilitating the city of Aba. We're working very closely with them to see how we can move Aba from what it is now to a much better and much nicer city. We're also expecting members of the Abia State government to also be here with us. SAIS, which is one of our programs we're co-funding with USAID, picked up the mantle of accountability and good governance and started the hashtag TalkNDI initiative that tracks Niger Delta institutions responsible for delivering services and produced a report titled The Citizen Report Card on the NDIs. That report covered 8 local government areas. I mean, that report also basically showed to those institutions that there's still more work to be done. There's still opportunity for them to improve on the service that they're providing. Of course, the Market Stool program, which is also supported by USAID and PIND, has also provided equipment support for women and youth farmers in Cross River and Delta states, addressing the constraints of access to finance. Market Stool and PIND, along with our partner, MAID, which is a DFID-funded project, also brokered working relationships between SMEs in the agric production. So these are just some highlights of some of the things that the NDDF has identified, followed through, and we'll see that that's where we want to go. Because part of the key things we want to see is that we don't want NDDF to be a talk show. It's not a jamboree, it's a place where we want to come, talk about issues, identify what the issues are, pick up action items and run with them. And then we'll come back the following year to report on some of the things that we do. There are a lot of conversations that happen in between each NDDF. And so continuing, I'd just like to say that PIN has been working towards a more peaceful and equitable Niger Delta for over 5 years. And we have great confidence in the region's ability to realize its fullest potential. However, even I know that the current times are challenging, and we have recession and all of that. And the collapse of the global oil prices has taken its toll, the hardest on the 9 states of the Niger Delta region, because to a large extent, our economy was based on oil, and we have built it around that. So a low oil price means more pressure on the resources of the state and ability of the state to meet its own obligations. And all of this, of course, has also resulted in the reemergence of the violence of new militant groups. Despite numerous efforts by both private and public sector stakeholders to foster inclusive economic growth, little headway has been made on the way forward. In the face of these challenges, it is important to understand how we got here and how to articulate our vision of how to move from where we are to where we want to be. We are putting NDDF to the service of this need of reimagining a possible future, beginning with changing the narrative of the Niger Delta. We must promote a Niger Delta that ranks high in inclusive citizen participation in governance. We must promote a Niger Delta where state governments operate with the concept of transparency, accountability, and effectiveness. where diversity in economic pursuits are championed by state governments and executed openly, and a region that no longer grapples with violence, but where peace reigns. That's the Delta that we vision. And I'd like to encourage and enjoin all of you to join us in making that vision happen. Before I step out, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of some of our very dear friends and colleagues, members of the board of NDPI, who have traveled all the way from the US to join us at this forum. For a number of our directors, this is the very first NDDF they are attending. I mean, thanks for your support, and thanks for giving us the direction that we have given to us. I'd also like to thank the members of the PIN board who are also present here, and of course, particularly my dear friend, the executive director of NDPI, Heather Cobb. Thanks for making it here today with us. Thank you very much, and I look forward to very healthy and very robust conversation in the next couple of days. Have a blessed day.